Hey, this is Asaf Levavi from LickNRiff.com, and it's time for another Christmas special. Christmas is coming up, so we're going to learn how to play a fingerstyle arrangement of Silent Night. I've made this fingerstyle arrangement especially for you guys and girls on commission. One of your fellow viewers purchased a private lesson for Silent Night, and he decided to donate it for the community to enjoy. So thank you very much, private student slash viewer. All right, so first I'm gonna play it for you so you can see and hear how it goes. I kept it really simple so the beginners among you can play it too. So it goes like this. Okay, so as you've seen, this is quite simple. It's only got C, F, and G in it. Okay, now I'm going to teach you the way I play it, and then I'm going to show you a couple of ways you can play with it to make your own arrangement, your own interpretation of this. This is simple enough to be played in many, many different ways. So just one note before we begin, I like to put the entire C chord and the entire F chord on most of the time, because even though you only play this, okay, if you decide to rearrange it and play the higher notes as well, okay, then you have the option because you're already putting on the right fingers. Okay, so don't be lazy. Put on the entire chord instead of just playing the notes that you need to play. Just putting on the fingers that you need for the notes you need to play. That's why I always put the full chord on instead of just playing this. Okay, I put this on too. Okay, so let's start. You start with the C chord. And you play this. You play the bass on the A string, three on the A string, and the open G string. That's the first couple of notes of the song. And then I play 2-0 on the G string, but along with the second open G string, I play the G bass. On the E bass, the E bass string. And then I put the head of the C chord back on and I play both the D and A strings, okay, on 2 and 3 respectively. Okay, so what you get is a bass change, okay? So you don't just hear this, okay? Which is basically the same harmony. If you do this, then you have kind of a counterpoint going there, and that enriches the melody. So again, you can not play the G bass note. You don't have to do it, but that's the way I do it. So that's the first lick. Okay? Now, you can also hammer on the two. You can do this. Okay, you can do, or you can play instead of, you can play the G string, then hammering on two and pulling it off back to zero on the G string, like this. Okay, that's another option. See, you can play with the first lick already. So let's just go over the lick as it's written in the tab. A and G strings, okay? then to zero on the G string and the G bass along with the open G string. Yeah. Then the head of the C chord. Right? So just one last time. Right? And of course you can embellish it as you like. And then you play it again. Right? This lick comes around twice. And then this. Right? Now, this is G. It's this G. Okay? You put on 3 on the second string with your third finger and the G bass, 3 on the E bass string with your second finger. So you have both the first finger and the pinky free. So you can do this. Okay? 2 hammer on to 4 later on in the lick. First of all, you play the 2 threes. You play the second string and the sixth string. And then you play the second string again. Okay? You can harmonize with the G and D strings. Okay? That's another option. And then hammer on 2 to 4 on the G string. And you can harmonize with the D string. Or, better yet, with the B string. Making this kind of a country lick. So, got it? And then this. Now the lick, this is a C chord again. You just play the second string and the fifth string. Then you play the second string again. Then you play the third string. That's the lick. Now, what I just played was this. I played the D string right before I played the G string as a harmony. You can play them together. Okay, it works as well. Okay? You can play what? You wanted to get comfortable and remember that I'm in the middle of a lesson. So, you can play the entire chord throughout the lick. And on the third time, just don't play the second string. That's another option. And I just remember that I said we're gonna go over the variations later. Sorry. Couldn't wait. ADHD, remember? And then you play this. Now you can put on this F chord, okay, and just play it. Or you can add the low F bass on 1 on the E bass string with your thumb to make this chord a little more interesting. And you can also bar it. Okay, and then it's... But the disadvantage of the bar is that when you take the bar off of the first off of the first fret of the second string, then something about it sounds off because you're moving the rest of your fingers. So it makes the rest of the strings go a little bit out of tune for a second. So that's why I prefer this shape. Put on 1, 2, and 3 on the second, third, and fourth strings, 1, 2, and 3 fret-wise, and use your thumb, even if it's uncomfortable for you, it's just for a moment, on 1 on the E bass string. And pick this. Strings 3, 4, and 6. Then play the third string again. Then on the second string, you can play 1-0 or pull it off. Or, and you can also harmonize it, okay, with the third string or the third and fourth string. And then the third string again. Okay, that's the lick. And then C again. And you play the first lick again, the very first lick. Okay? Okay? With the G bass or without it. Same lick. Then you play the F lick again. Same lick. Then the same C lick again. And then this. Why am I putting these fingers on? Okay? This is G7. You can put it on right away or add the first finger when you need it. This time it's 3 and 3 on the 2nd and 6th strings. This time with your pinky and 3rd finger, because that's the most comfortable way to add the 1st finger on 1 on the E string. So you have 1 on the E string, 3 on the 2nd string, and the G bass, 3 on the E bass string. So you play this. Okay, the 2nd and 5th strings, and then the 2nd string again. Then, one on the E string, then on the 2nd string, the B string, you play 3-0. And then you play C. The notes to play if you're just playing the harmony are the 2nd string and the 5th string. But this is a good place to play the entire chord, except for the E string. Don't play the E string. And then A minor, or A minor 7, both work here. Now A minor, you know, A minor 7, A minor with an open G string. And the melody note here is the open E string, the open first string. So just play the chord, you can strum it if you want, you can play strings 1, 2, 3, and 5. Doesn't really matter. You can play the 1st and 5th strings. And then, don't worry, we're gonna go over everything after we're done, and we're almost done. Then it's this. It's another C chord. Oh, by the way, I forgot the A minor chord at the beginning, so there are 4 chords here. Instead of 3. So, it's basically the 4 chord song. If you haven't noticed by now, it's C, F, G, and A minor. So, yet another 4 chord song. So, the C chord, and you play the 2nd and 5th strings, and then the 3rd string, then the 4th string. Okay? Very simple, just an arpeggio of the chord. Then put the G bass on. You don't have to put anything else on this time. And you play the G bass with the open G string. Then 3 and 0 on the D string. I do it with my pinky. You can do it with your 3rd finger or your 2nd one. Doesn't really matter, it all sounds exactly the same. I do this because it's the closest way to go back to the C chord. Okay, so then C. Okay, the note here is, the melody note is the C bass, so that's a good place to play the chord. So, and you can end with C or C with a high G with 3 on the E string. That's just, you play the C chord in any way you like. You can play it lavishly, you can play it like this. More extravagantly. Here it is. So We're done learning this, so let's go over it one more time. C, G bass, C. Again. G, C, F, C. Exactly the same lick as the beginning lick. The beginning lick. F. Again, C. G7. C, A minor, or A minor 7. A minor 7 sounds better. C. G. C. Or even... did just now. This really doesn't fit in, but anyway, I slid 3 to 5 on the second string, played 3 on the E string, then slid right back from 5 to 3 on the second string, then 1 on the B string again. It really doesn't fit. I was joking. Please don't do this. Okay, so, or do, you don't have to listen to me. I'm only the teacher here. So, okay, I'll let you go practice this. But before you do, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And, you know, go download the tab from the website. It's free. Everything is for free. Have a Merry Christmas. Play this for your family, your friends, your enemies. And if you want to give something back to LickNRiff, even though everything is for free, there's a donation button on the website. And I'd appreciate any donation whatsoever. It all goes right back into LickNRiff, into making these lessons, these arrangements, and the videos, and editing them, and uploading them. It all takes time and work. So, I'll see you in the next lesson. Thank you very much for watching, and have fun with this. And Merry Christmas. Bye for now.